So we're going to wrap it up with another Edith Piaf number, but before we do, I just want to tell you a little bit about more about her. I feel like in more recent history, we think about her as just being kind of a big hot mess, and she was. She was. But she was also doing some good things. Like I said in the beginning, she was helping her musician friends who were no longer welcome in her country, but she helped them stay hidden. She paid for their food. So when people talk about the French Resistance, they talk about it in all these different levels, and some people say that if you just gave somebody money that you weren't part of the French Resistance, but I think that's up to you to decide whether you think that's somebody who's just sitting idly by or somebody who's doing what they could to help out. And Edith Piaf did. She toured into Germany at French labor camps. And some people will say she was performing just as much for the Germans as for the French. Regardless, she let her French Resistance friends come along, and they took pictures of Edith Piaf with the prisoners, and then they came back months later, and having made ID cards out of those pictures to help those people escape. And then years later, she actually heard from some of those people who managed to get away. So it's all those little things, and I think this time of year particularly, it's easy to gloss over all the little things that people do. But sometimes it's fun to live in those stories a little bit. And as Edith Piaf would say, it's fun to see the world through rose-colored glass. La vie en rose. When he holds me in his arms, I see the life in rose.